This channel is for viewers of 18 years of age, so if you're 18, right on. If not, you know the drill. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. It's XDBX Mitch on the mic, and letting y'all know this is going to be a little bit of a seed to harvest video of my auto closet, as well as featuring my melon farm tent with the lorenas and my tomato plants. And I'm also going to be showing you guys my clones as well, so we're going to jump into that. So far in the training department, there hasn't been a whole lot going on. There's just been a bit of LST training, a bit of defoliation here and there, heavy on the newts right now because they are going to be flipping to flower here pretty soon. And yeah, pretty much just on cruise control right now. Now the tomatoes you do see there are transplanted currently and moved to a different tent, and the clones have also been transplanted and are doing a lot better than they were before. All three have made it and are successfully cloned. Now to get these clones started, all I had to do was basically prepare my medium. I use a soilless medium, which is a high porosity pro mix, and it works great for starting clones. It works great for just planting all your plants. It's a general purpose soilless mix. This clone, I'm not too sure what's happening with it. We'll get to that on a later date, but it's just looking yellowish, deathly. I thought it was coming back. It looks like it is, but we'll see. We'll see. Moving on into further weeks with the closet, I had to perform, have had to perform some further defoliations. I don't like to defoliate too much because I don't want to cause too much stress to the plants, stunts their growth, yada yada yada. Autoflowers are very, very tedious, not like photos. You only have so much time to train them to do all your defoliations and whatnot before they hit their flowering stage. And then of course, once they flip to flower, you don't want to mess with them too much. And then I usually defoliate my biggest defoliation around the second week of flower, and then hitting week 5 is when I go into my full defoliation. So that way I get all my top colas, everything spread right out. And then of course that's where the LST training comes into play as well, because then you got a nice full spread out plant, nice even canopy, and then everything's just coming along. You got all just nice top colas, and that's what you're searching for. Mixing the nutrients for your autoflowers is probably one of the most tedious things because, like I said, they only have so much time in their vegetative state as opposed to their flowering stage. Their flowering stage is about, you know, usual flowering, you know, 7 to 9 week flowering stages, but when it comes to the vegetative stage, that's when it comes into a bigger situation. You've only got so much time to give them those veggie newts rather than giving them their bloom newts. So it's a big key part in the beginning stages of the autoflowers, is getting them through their vegetative state getting them nice and bulked up. One big tip I will give everybody, if you've made it this far, is that if you do keep your, if you use a grow micro bloom three-part system, try and keep your nitrogen, which is your grow, and your bloom nutrient kind of the same. Keep it almost the same through about 2 to 3 weeks throughout your flowering stage, and then drop your grow down, bring your bloom up. You know what I mean? Like, it's kind of difficult to explain, but if you give it the grow and the bloom at the same time through the flowering stage, you get more of a stretch, you get a taller plant, and overall just a better looking canopy. Like to keep consistent on my waterings. I do check every day. I'll start off with a low amount of watering. I don't like to underwater too much, but overwatering is a big problem. Now, underwatering is a easy fix. It's a quicker bounce back than if it were to be overwatered. So I like to start off with lower waterings at first, and then work my way up to heavier waterings. I like my plant to dry out at least every day to every other day. And after 2 whole weeks, we are looking at some nicer bud structure going on. They're definitely plumping up. I believe this is the week 3 mark of the closet. And I've just upped the bloom, the bud fusion nutrient. And I'll be giving it the jet fuel here. It's another thing. If you're using specific part systems, it's key to know when to give your nutrients to your autoflowers. I was told this once, and I'm listening to it now, because if you give them to them too late, it's gonna stunt them. If you give them to them too early, it's gonna stunt them. There's so many key factors to autoflowers, so it's really a touch and go system when it comes to these types of plants. If you're a first time grower and you're into experimenting, then definitely give them a try. But photoperiods, if you're looking for higher yields and stuff like that, photoperiods is definitely a way to go. You're not going to get too big of a yield coming out of an autoflower. You might get 2 to 3 ounces tops out of an autoflower. Now, your photos, you're going to get, 6 to 7, depending on how big you grow. For anybody that has noticed, I have added one new LED light to the closet, as well as a new filtration system. So it's a Vivo Sun 4-inch inline fan and carbon filter. The filter was gifted to me by a friend, Smokey 805 Genetics. You can go check him out on Instagram. He also hooked me up with the speed controller and 4-inch inline fan from my melonfarm, which I will be showing you guys here pretty darn quick. Oh, look at this. Look at that. So there's the tomatoes, everybody. The tomatoes are doing much, much better. The Lorena's breath is currently on week 5 and is heading into the jet fuel stage. So those buds are going to be nice and plumped up. the homemade trellis did prove useful in many cases. It made the bud structures a lot bigger as they go down the stems and whatnot, spread the plant out a lot more evenly, and got a better canopy. So trellis nets are definitely a must. And after a few weeks later, yeah, you know what? I thought this music was epic, so we're just gonna go with it. I mean, come on, guys, can't disagree. This music is awesome. It's epic. I'm gonna shut up now. Let's get back to business. Yeah, let's not go into that. No, I don't want to get a copyright ban. Anyway, the tomatoes are doing much, much better as they've been transplanted into 2-gallon pots. They're currently in, I believe, week 2 of flower. Taking the innovating plant product nutrients, you can use them in your veggie gardens, you can use them in your weed gardens, you can use them in your flower gardens, anywhere, guys. These nutrients are definite musts to have in your grows. Hydroponic systems, cocoa, soil, doesn't matter. They will work towards your needs because that's how awesome they are. I mean, come on, look at the bud structures. Look at the formations of those terps. And hopefully in the next few weeks when we do cut the nutrients off and add the Typhoon Cleanse, we should see some nice fade happening. That nice autumn fade coming in on the flowers is one of the best things to look at. And yes, I did add a nice little butterfly in there. Don't laugh at me. Shout out to Famiers LED for sending me over the Famiers TF1000. You can get yourself a 5% off discount using the Famiers TF at their website. It's only for the website, not for Amazon. Sorry for that. Also, don't forget to go over and show some love to my sponsors. If you guys are looking to switch over to some new nutrients, or you're just new to the game and you're looking for some nutrients, definitely check them out at innovatingplantproducts.com. They got a whole lineup. They got tester boxes. And yeah, definitely check them out. It's a must have, guys. Also, go head on over to my other sponsors at hybridseedcanada.com for great prices on seeds. All right, guys, I'll catch you on the next one. Stay lifted.